Yes, yes. Well, we give thanks to the consciousness, you know. And we say, we listen to you every time. Brother Jerry and Muta and people like you give the real inspiration, you know. And we say, to all the people them, sometimes we look in our life and we say, why people can't accept the good thing? When you hear the good thing, it's like people get mad about the good thing. Yeah, and
turn upside down, but we're not gonna make it talk too long. Wrap it up.
Yeah. So we are say try, because one part of the Bible said the things I should see myself doing, we're not do it, and the things what we shouldn't be doing, we are do. So we have to get it right, you know.
When good is present, evil something or the other. Hello, how you doing?
Pretty good, Sister Andrea. It's a blessing, Rastafari. And the celebration here as we witness, I want to mention a brother from in the hills named Franklin. He was one of the fighters, the resistance, one of the resistance against the invasion of Iraq at Carroll Gardens. And my father tell me, said a man went just up in a cow skin, a serious thing. Franklin, I mean, you nobody mentioned about him, but you don't know.
You mean Woodall Franklin. Yeah, man, we talk about Woodall every day, man. But give thanks to Bird and give to that. How you doing, sister?
Fine, thank you, sir.
See your eye from the mic, you know, but go on top, man. Everything all right?
Yeah, man. I love to see the eye.
You've been on the battlefield?
Yes, sir. From the beginning.
How you feel about what you're seeing unfolding here?
I feel pleased if it's that you can unite. I feel very pleased that you can unite brothers and sisters. You the chairs there. Oh, no, I don't come out for the vibes yet. I pick up an energy when all of us was together. I can't come down. I feel like I'm flying. I feel glad all my people come together and keep the peace and quiet and nothing ever go wrong. It's just a seed to the deal we're going to plant. You understand me? Yeah.
Give thanks, my sister. Six of Gloria. We came to you earlier, but you were deep in the mile, my sister. How you doing?
There, I give thanks, you know. Best of yourself, Sister Andrea, thank you for your wonderful work. You know, I know you don't love praises, but I saw you go, heal Jamaica people, you know, and Rockford, which part I know the most time nowadays, heal them people, and I heal Flagstaff, Maroontown, because I know down here and I work also, you know. I know Mama G is a one way, I know it's like a, if I should say that, it's like a force there, you know, that I see things happening and the spirit move me and I do what I'm supposed to do. So the first of March, the spirit move me and I've been preparing since December flags to put up at Flagstaff, because I've been studying the history, and the history of Jamaica is not correct. And when I go down deep, both orally and written, you know, and find out what was going on and the whole history of the Trelawney Town Maroons up here, you know, comparing to other Maroon Town adjacent to them, you know, and the whole trampling down of not just Maroon history, but Jamaica, and one of the richest history of Jamaica is based in that Maroon Town. The first garrison in Jamaica is in Maroon Town up in the hills here, Old Trelawney Town, where the ancestor was deployed.
So basically what you're saying, my sister, is that you have been looking again at what has been presented, been studying this, and is in the process of rewriting this.
Yes, so I put up 7 flags up there the first of March, recognizing the peace treaty signed in that community. We recognize it, and we reclaim, the program we did was entitled Part Clearing and Reclaiming of Our Sovereignty.
As a Maroon descendant to my sister, you know, that means we have a lot of reconciliation for though, because as a descendant of the Maroons, I do not recognize no treaty, you know. And we're not going to quarrel about that right just now, my sister. But we're not going to recognize the treaty right just now. But so we have a lot of reconciliation. But in terms of where you see going...
I had to recognize it because it is and did happen. Not recognizing the work of it, but the fact that it did happen there.
All right, this is my sister, Sister Gloria. I'm a good sister. Both of us are descendants of Maroons, but we disagree upon what we ancestors do. Give me a minute there, my brother. Thank you very much, Amin. How you doing, Amin?
Well, I'm there a long time and no talk.
All right, we're having a feedback.
Yeah, man, long time and no talk today, you know, from back in the days. Empress Andrea, Akaba, Secret Rock.
Akaba.
That was the name from back in the days, and you still carry that name there. Yes, warriors, we give thanks to the eye, and hills are listening to the eye upon the work coming out. No say you will rise, terrible as you are, you know. And we give thanks to your voice on our radio station. And we there to do the work, we are support everything, and we see the youth them have come. and we're glad for that as elders. So give thanks.
Give thanks, but I mean, who go get water for me? Thank you. I mean, holy water for me. How you doing, Mrs. Self?
I'm great. I'm really happy this morning because it gives me a strength to know that I can continue with what I am doing and how I am living, because I have children in schools, in government schools, and they're facing pressure. You know, they have to be changing them from school to school.
Why?
Because for them to be comfortable, because I have to be putting them in private schools, and when I even do that and I spend a lot of money, you're still getting pressure.
Because they're Rastafarians?
Because they're Rastafarians. Children saying that their hair stink, saying that they don't smell good. When my children are the most brilliant students, because my daughter got the highest grade on that other school for grade 4 literacy. And them smell really, really good, because what they wear is hemp. It's hemp they wear on the skin, and the children, because they don't understand the smell and they've never smelt it before.
How old are your children?
My daughter is 10. Her name is Zalika Morgan, and my son is Shawazi Morgan, and he's 7. And they're brilliant children.
In which school is this happening?
A school by the name of Harding Hall, and the principal did not help me. She did not give me no justice.
What is the name of the school?
Harding Hall Prep in Hanover. It's a private school. It's in Green Island. It's in Green Island of Hanover. And my children got no justice. She told me that I was to change what they were wearing on their skin for them to be in the school and feel comfortable. And I said no.
Are you serious, my sister?
That's what the principal told me.
So what is it? Where is the situation now? What has happened?
Took them from out of the school, and where they're at now, they're more comfortable and they're more accepted, because I told the principal what happened to them, and she made sure that no one, absolutely no one, troubles them.
You see, this is a problem, because, and that is why when we say we have to seek justice for Coral Gardens, it's relevant.
It's relevant because what is happening now is because nothing was done then. The nip it in the butt.
Sometimes we have to stand far. Sometimes we have to return to the past to correct the mistakes which we have made. And this time the state has made. That's why we're saying acknowledgement, recognition, reparations.
Yes, and we need it right now. Our children are asking for it because they question me. I can't stop talking. I'm too opinionated. I'm constantly talking in my house. So when they hear me utter words, they know. They know their history, and they know what we are fighting for. Because we need to fight for it. Because if we did not do what we were supposed, my children would not be uncomfortable in a school situation that they have to be changing them from school to schools. When I go to Canada, they are accepted. People love them.
So are they comfortable now where they are?
Comfortable now, and they're doing quite well, and they have no problem.
The issue is that other Rastafarian children passing through that school will face similar problems.
And the thing is that she's trying to justify the fact that there have been other Rasta children there, and there have never been any problem before. So it must be what they're wearing that is creating the problem. And I am saying it cannot be. It has to be a prejudice. It has to be a prejudice.
This is really, really serious, and it's something we have to look at and look into. My sister, we'll talk. Let us talk about this. Let us talk. How are you doing, my brother? Donahue Kelly, zone manager, K9 Guard Security Limited. You asked me a while ago, what about the security guard?
Well, first of all, I am proud to say it's a pleasure to provide free security in this organization tonight. I am very proud.
You provided free security here today, last night and today?
Free of cost.
Thank you very much, Mr. Garvey. You see how you look like Mr. Garvey?
Well, I'm a Rasta friend from Bar Westman. I went to him, so I look like Garvey, brother.
You really look like a young Garvey. Thank you very much. You couldn't do no better.
And this is one of the men that I emulate very much, Mr. Robin Jerry Small.
So you're in very good company, and that's why you have on the hand.
When I grew up, I wanted to be like him. I just want to have the information.
You're on the right track because you have the heart already. He was looking for you, no, Jerry, and he said, where's Jerry Small? And I said, he might want a heart like yours. Thank you very much.
Take care, sis, Sandra.
Thank you very much for providing security. Right. Gonna take a break? Do we take a break? Or do we talk to one more person? Okay, let's talk to... Hello, my brother. How are you doing?
Yes, man. They are trying to have a good time, you know, and celebrate the days when we're back in the major again, in the ghetto where they come to kill this little seed named Rastafari. which was a little baby. It's nothing strange in the Bible, because when Moses, when Moses come up here, they want to kill him. Them say when Jesus come.
Don't tap my mic.
Yeah, them say when Jesus come, another man would want to kill him. So every time I see it come up, he said the truth. Who is God? God is love, God is truth, God is right, God is justice. But if William, God, Marcus, Gabriel, Paul, both come and speak justice, them said to kill him. So now this little seed that were born in Jamaica named Rastafari were slaughtered by, were trying to slaughter him. Buster Manto tried to slaughter him and say, and them dead bodies, like a seed can't live. But glory to Rastafari, I have seen this little seed spreading bigger and bigger and bigger, because no one knows that his imperial majesty is the creator. Who are you from 1930?
So when thank you, my brother. We're just going to give the sister a quick talk because we're moving for the news. Are you the sisters?
Greetings, Sister Andrea. Thank you, and Moot, and all the IRFM crew for all the wonderful work you has done. It is beautiful, and I love it, Sister Andrea.
We're loving it too, as the cloud.
Rastafari, bless the eye. Greetings in the name of His Imperial Majesty, Emperor Haile Selassie I, and Empress Menenhai. Greetings to all my brothers and sisters, and all my children. They are listening now.
And we have to break.
Okay. Ashai and Tamara and all my grandchildren, Kim.
We have to break. Thank you very much as we go for the news. Time on IRFM is now 8:45.
Why identify yourself, Selena? I don't want to identify people. Identify yourself.
Well, I'm Raskova, you know.
Raskova from them time there until now.
Yeah, from
our time. From history.
Yeah, well, right now, you know, reach a level where Rastas reach a very significant era. It's the way like you reach a goal, but we don't really achieve it.
We're not kicking the ball in there.
No, but we reach the goal right now.
Yeah.
So, we have shown that we have a popular participation. That means the governance of us is right here. So, what we are doing now is advising those persons who are in responsibility, not so well them is government, because the government is really the vendors and the farmers who get up early in the morning and jump and do this and do this and do that. But the honorables work with the rebels, and we still have to work with them because it's the Jamaica still. So we are advising them, and I tell you, I've been taking my advice now. Yeah, man.
Okay, so are you my problem? Are you my problem then?
Blame me too.
Yeah.
Because we're not doing enough. But now, like how we reach this, and I've had a popular consultation with every brethren and things like that, we have agreed that it's full time now that the police force be changed. Like how them change our name and change our places, we all change that.
Really? You say change the police force name?
Yeah,
I fire the police.
Don't fire them, man. It's good people. It's my black
brothers. No, where you want them though? Where you want them though?
Change the name from force. Let them put on a service.
Yes.
I tell you, I've been in dialogue with them from a long time, you know.
Like from force to protector or something like that.
Yeah, some.
I agree with you, know. You don't agree with you.
Tell me anything, no. All we reach here right now in the system, it need a comprehensive cooperation.
Yes.
I didn't want to say even we start with police, you know, police talks we good and we talk them good and tell we all them deeds.
Yeah.
So it's a time of reconciliation. We are our own means.
Yeah.
I want to tell you, nobody not holding us back. It's we the black people holding back ourselves. We are our own enemies. All of us are excellent people who can do good things.
Yeah.
And the rest of potential is also going to launch a leadership for plenty. We have discussed that over the years, and we're going far right now. I want to party with the pan.
All right, when you say we, who you are talking about?
Well, the Rastas, you know, the soldiers of Rasta all over, and when you say we, you know.
You mean like Miguel and all them, man?
Everything, man.
Miguel, you know what we're talking about? Because me and I say we, and
you know,
so like a we business. Oh, yeah. That me know what you talk about, you know, but it sound like you involved.
Nigga, you involved?
Yeah, man.
Oh, yeah. Him talk then. That's not talk. Musa, you involved?
You have to know I'm involved in that.
From 1983.
Yeah, you have to know I'm involved
from
in
that. From 1983, I called up in a Motown.
All right.
And up at Ronald Williams.
You see, no, we're going to, all right, no, we don't know. We don't want to go back to the time.